sold for sex.
They were on drugs.
At just 9 years old.
How can someone, an adult, do this to me?
One girl grows up plotting her revenge.
If I don't hurt them, they're gonna hurt me.
And sees it backfire.
He bought me a drink, and I don't even remember anything after that.
On today's 700 Club.
Well, welcome to this edition of the 700 Club. We've got an exciting show. Mm-hmm. I didn't realize that my co-hostess here can pick politicians and leaders. Did you know you could do that?
Absolutely. No, not at all.
What gave
I
you
am
the,
not claiming that.
What gave you the clue?
That what? That I can't
About
pick them?
What? No, Condoleezza Rice is now at the head of the list for VP.
Well, of course. Are you surprised? But here's the key, though. You know, she may be at the head of the list, but does she want to be at the head of the list? That's the question. I asked her that.
You asked if she
I
wanted
sure
to
did.
Be president or vice president?
Of course I did.
And here she is saying that?
Yeah, actually, that's one of the interviews I've interviewed. I've interviewed her several different times. And the last time I interviewed her, I asked that very question. I said, would you ever run for president or to be vice president? And her response was simply, no.
Well, we'll see. Okay,
yeah.
Well, she's the... According to Drudge and all these guys that write these blogs, she's a woman, she's black, she's got a foreign policy experience, and she interviewed with Christie, and who she told her she knows how to cook.
And a lot of other things. Yeah. But more important, you left out one other adjective. She's brilliant. That woman is brilliant and so knowledgeable about so many different subjects.
Okay.
I think she'd be a phenomenal person in the vice president. Position beyond.
But you picked her in advance. I'm telling you, from humble beginnings. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah.
Well, in the news, it's the Civil War you aren't hearing about, and the most brutal battle in the world right now. What is it? It's Muslim fighting Muslim. And as somebody said, when your enemies are fighting each other, don't get involved.
We're talking about the war between Muslims in Syria. Chris Mitchell has a story from Jerusalem.
Grainy cell phone video, brutal fighting, Islamic shouts, and failed negotiations marked a 17-month-long Syrian uprising.
Bashar Assad and his Alawite elite are fighting a war of self-preservation against what is essentially a Sunni revolt against them.
This revolt pits Sunni against Shiite.
The strategic fault line of conflict in the region between the Iran-led regional bloc on the one hand, and I would say the Sunni bloc, you know, or the Sunni group of states, including Saudi Arabia, that fault line right now is running through Syria.
That fault line splits the Middle East into two large Islamic camps. The larger one includes the Sunni nations of Egypt, Turkey, the Gulf states, and the epicenter of Sunni Islam, Saudi Arabia. Iran leads the Shiite Islam group that includes its proxy Hezbollah in Lebanon and Syria, while President Assad and much of his regime technically belong to a sect called Alawite, they align themselves with Shiite Islam. So with both groups calling themselves Muslims, why do they fight each other? The answer goes back to the beginning of Islam.
The Shiites believe that Islam should have been led from the very beginning by a caliph who came from the family of the Prophet himself, in fact, from the family of the cousin of the Prophet called Ali. The Sunnis believe that the caliph, namely the leader of the Islamic community, the commander of the faithful, should be elected from the community.
This theological disagreement led to the great Islamic divide.
And there was tremendous enmity and tremendous hatred between the two parts.
That hatred is now being fought on Syrian soil.
And it's a reflection of this main struggle in the Middle East today.
In this struggle, Iran funds and arms the Assad regime, while the Saudis and other Sunni powers back the opposition, which includes elements of the Muslim Brotherhood. The U.S. is lining up behind the opposition groups.
There's growing evidence that on the ground and away from the public eye, there is American personnel who are helping to direct resources and weaponry to the rebels.
Speier says the U.S. and the West have in effect given the job of building up the Syrian opposition to the Saudis. Unfortunately, that opposition is becoming more radical and Islamist.
To put it simply, if you give the Saudis the job of creating an insurgency for you, well, don't be surprised if you get a Sunni Islamist insurgency.
The outcome of this struggle between these two Middle East titans will greatly determine the future and fate of the Middle East. It's a conflict that Israeli leaders are watching closely. If the Syrian opposition topples Assad, it's possible that Israel could have a second radical Islamic regime on its borders. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Now, you haven't heard that much before, ladies and gentlemen, but this is the conflict that's coming up. The followers of Ali, the Shias, versus the Sunnis. And they can get very bloody. It's like cousin against cousin, and they're going to be destroying one another. And as I say, when your enemies are killing themselves, stay out of the conflict. Let them just go ahead and do it. But we shouldn't be on the side of either one. I've been very cautious about saying we ought to help the Syrian opposition. I don't like what Assad is doing, but his daddy did worse. In the city of Hama, he butchered 20 to 30,000 members of the Brotherhood who were rising against him during his regime, and he didn't stand for it. So his son says, well, I'm going to do like my daddy, and I'm going to make sure that these people don't take me from power. Isn't that interesting, though? The Alawites, the Shias, and the Sunnis. You'll hear more about it, but you heard it here maybe first. Well, Lee Webb has the rest of our top stories from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Pat, the Obama campaign is making a big issue of Mitt Romney's wealth, and the president continually says the rich need to start paying their fair share in taxes. But a new survey finds that most Americans still respect the wealthy. A market research firm called Globespan conducted the poll. It found that 58% agree with the statement that most rich people in my country deserve their wealth. Other surveys have shown similar findings, Pat.
Well, the president studied at the school of Saul Alinsky, and Saul Alinsky was for class warfare. And so what Obama wants to do is create class envy and class warfare. But the American people think that the lowest among us can aspire to be the highest among us. And actually, Obama shows that himself. He's a mixed race. Father was Kenyan. His mother was American. And he comes out of essentially nothing to become president. So we all hope to aspire that we can have a better life for our children and that we can achieve some level of wealth. And people who preach class warfare don't win. George McGovern tried it, and he lost. And Obama's going to lose if he continues. Lee.
Pat, Penn State's Board of Trustees says it takes full responsibility for the failures that led to the Jerry Sandusky child abuse scandal. The board made its statement after an investigation by former FBI Director Louis Freeh. That report says university officials, including legendary football coach Joe Paterno, looked the other way and seemed more concerned about the school's reputation and Coach Sandusky than his victims. Mark Martin has the story.
Former FBI director and lead investigator into the scandal, Louis Freeh, described the actions of Penn State's top officials as callous and shocking.
The most powerful men at Penn State failed to take any steps for 14 years to protect the children who Sandusky victimized.
Freeh accuses them of covering up the Jerry Sandusky child sex abuse scandal to avoid bad publicity.
Although concern to treat the child abuser humanely was expressly stated, no such sentiments were ever expressed by them to Sandusky's victims.
Last month, a jury found Sandusky guilty of 45 counts of abusing children. In Freeh's 267-page report, he also blames late Penn State head football coach Joe Paterno, former President Graham Spanier, Vice President Gary Schultz, and Athletic Director Tim Curley. According to the report, Paterno admitted to learning about an incident in 2001 involving Sandusky and a boy in a shower. He told Curley instead of calling police, but no one contacted the authorities.
There's really no new facts involved in this, just some new interpretations that, that really won't take away from anything that he's done.
The attorney for one of Sandusky's victims at his criminal trial also now plans to sue Penn State.
This was a systemic failure from the bottom to the top.
Penn State is pledging reform.
An event like this can never happen again in the Penn State University community. Judge Freeh's report is both sad and sobering.
Mark Martin, CBN News.
Yeah, and investigators also found that Penn State's Board of Trustees is partially to blame for not holding those top leaders accountable. And the report gives lawyers more information for major civil lawsuits that are sure to follow against Penn State University. The school year has ended for millions of children across the country, but the workload for school officials continues. And as John Jessup reports, those seeking wisdom from a higher authority are getting encouragement from, of all places, Washington.
50 years after the Supreme Court handed down its ruling on school prayer, the subject still stirs strong emotions on both sides. But the ban on school-sponsored prayer fits into a larger debate about prayer in the public square.
We are not asking that it be forced on anyone.
Two-term Michigan Congressman Tim Walberg believes prayer is a part of America's DNA. He points to the founding fathers who sought divine guidance when drafting the Constitution.
It was like second nature that all of a sudden it was stopped and said, let's go to prayer.
As a former pastor and now in public office, prayer plays a major role in Walberg's life. He's part of a network of legislators advancing laws that protect America's religious liberties. One way he's trying to do that is with a House resolution supporting school boards that start their meetings with prayer, something over which some school boards and other local bodies have faced lawsuits in recent years.
If you want to pray at a town hall meeting or at a school board meeting or in the halls of Congress, that ought to be acceptable in the United States.
Walberg bases his resolution on the fact that school boards are deliberative bodies and argues that it's constitutional based on a 1983 Supreme Court case that acknowledged prayer is so deeply embedded in America's history and tradition that a public body making laws and invoking divine guidance is not in violation of the First Amendment's Establishment Clause.
Court rulings appear to be trending toward the other side of the argument. Earlier this year, the Supreme Court refused to hear an appeal from a Delaware school district where school board meetings started in prayer.
Opponents say the effort to promote Judeo-Christian values supports one religion over another.
It creates a precedent, or at least the appearance, that that particular religious perspective has some type of special relationship with the government. And the government really shouldn't be taking a stand like that.
As for Walberg, he says his resolution doesn't aim to infringe on anyone's freedom, rather to acknowledge the role and the power of prayer.
We're not pushing on other people and saying you have to do this. It's promoted freedom in this country and in the world, and we want to continue it.
John Jessup, CBN News, Capitol Hill.
And we will keep you posted on that story. Well, some simple weight loss techniques are proving effective. A new study published in the Journal of the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics recommends three simple ways to lose weight, and accountability is the key. The study showed that women who didn't skip meals lost 8 pounds more than those who did. Women who completed food journals lost about 6 pounds more. And those who ate lunch out at least once a week lost 5 fewer pounds than those who ate out less. Pat, self-control, the key.
I really think that's what it amounts to. But you can, you know, if you eat certain foods, they make you hungry. You eat more high glycemic carbs, they create a craving. If you eat sugar, you want more sugar. You eat sweets, you want more sweets. It's just something about it. Whereas if we eat fresh vegetables and protein and we get plenty of sleep, we don't eat as much.
Yeah, but you know what? The journal factor really is important because think about it. How many times are we in the kitchen and we kind of nibble? We see a cookie, we eat it while we're cooking, or we have a handful of potato chips while we're doing this. And so next thing you know, we're eating all these empty calories, but we don't even know we're doing it. You start to journal what you eat, and all of a sudden you look at it like, oh, good googly goo, I've been eating that much.
I haven't got time for some stupid food journal, but I'm sure it'll work. All right, what's next? Go ahead.
All right, Pat.
All right.
Coming up, it has the potential to create jobs and cut our dependence on foreign oil. But something is standing in the way.
When the pipeline started out in the 1970s, we moved about 700,000 barrels a day in the first year, and it quickly ramped up to 2.1 million barrels a day. Today, we're moving about 600,000 barrels a day, which is lower than any amount we've ever seen before.
So who's cutting off our oil supply? Find out up next. Then later on the 700 Club, we're gonna bring it on online. So here's the deal. If you have a question for Pat, because you know he loves to answer them, all you gotta do is log on to CBN.com.
John Mapes is 42. Mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? 60? 40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
Monday, the lone survivor from the Navy SEALs' deadliest conflict.
Get me out of here and I'll tell everybody how brave these guys fought.
And how he's serving his country off the battlefield. Plus, Billboard's number one Christian artist. The high-octane music of Sean Locke.
In a live show, in a live setting, people get to see that energy.
Monday on the 700 Club.
You want to play what if? What if we as a nation were no longer had to be so dependent on foreign oil? Well, many people say we really don't have to be dependent. They say the answer to most of our energy problems lies right here in America, in the oil fields of that great big state, north of the 48, the fields of Alaska. So why aren't we using it? Guess what? Your government and the out-of-control Environmental Protection Agency. Chuck Holston has this story from the land of the midnight sun.
Alaska is the home of crude oil reserves that experts say could provide a large percentage of America's energy for decades. Up here, most Alaskans agree that the only way to reduce our dependence on foreign energy is to boost Alaskan oil production.
When the pipeline started out in the 1970s, we moved about 700,000 barrels a day in the first year, and it quickly ramped up to 2.1 million barrels a day. Today, we're moving about 600,000 barrels a day, which is lower than any amount we've ever seen before.
Michelle Egan works for the company that manages the Alaskan pipeline and says it has the potential to move a lot more oil than it does right now.
Today, the Trans-Alaska Pipeline delivers about 11% of the nation's domestic crude supply. At one time, that was about 25%. It could easily be 15-20%.
Prudhoe Bay, Alaska, is North America's largest oil field and the beginning of the Trans-Alaskan Pipeline. Output here has been dropping for years, however, and if you talk to the oil workers, they'll say it's because of permits.
When some permits you're compliant with some permits, you're out of compliance with other permitting agencies. The contradictory permitting between state and federal agencies seems to be a problem.
Nothing can happen up here without dozens, if not hundreds, of permits. And the bureaucracies overseeing the process make the IRS look streamlined. Far-reaching environmental regulations and taxes put on oil companies mean new exploration has ground to a standstill.
The last couple of years, our business has really dropped down due to what has been happening up here. The equipment's parked in the yard. We can't, none of it hasn't been rented because of that reason. No new wells are being drilled. Nobody's doing any production up here. Everything's just completely went on standstill.
They're all losing their job. You can tell the population from last year to this year. I mean, it's went down a tremendous amount of people.
Oil companies are reluctant to comment because any criticism of the process could make business even more difficult. But Rebecca Logan of the Alaskan Support Industry Alliance was happy to explain further.
There are a lot of challenges that are facing Alaska oil production today. The largest challenges are the permitting challenges that come from the federal government and from the state government. Our most pressing need is to fill our pipeline. But we have a lot of barriers that have been put up by the federal government and barriers that have been put up by the state government.
None of the large federally controlled projects are moving forward at this time. So what is the holdup?
And we have this rogue agency, the EPA here, that they do what they want to do.
and they are out of control, and they are an agency that is full of people who are not elected officials, who have all kinds of authority, and who have stopped progress on resource development here by denying permits or rescinding permits that they've given. EPA has blocked the companies that are trying to start these resource development projects every step of the way.
If these issues aren't solved soon, the results could be drastic.
Well, the pipeline was designed to be a warm oil pipeline, so it was designed to move warm crude oil. But as the crude oil drops in the pipe, it gets colder as it moves from Prudhoe Bay to Valdez, 800 miles. So with that cold comes problems with water dropout, ice buildup, wax. There are technical challenges to running the pipeline at low throughputs, but it's probably the economic challenges that could come first, and it won't be feasible to run the pipeline at a certain point.
Here at pipeline headquarters in Anchorage, engineers are working to try and keep the oil flowing at lower and lower levels, because if it ever stops, the consequences for Alaska and America will be grim.
If the pipeline's forced to shut down, the law says it must be removed and the land restored to its pristine state. If that happens, America will have lost its most reliable means of acquiring domestic crude.
Well, Alaska is absolutely the answer to our domestic energy needs. Our most pressing need as a nation is to reduce our dependence on foreign oil, and the best way to do that is to fill the Alaska pipeline.
Chuck Holton, CBN News, Prudhoe Bay, Alaska.
You know, those bureaucrats somehow deep inside feel they're doing a service. But they hate oil, they hate drilling, they hate development, they hate manufacturing, they hate coal. They hate the things that make this nation economically self-sufficient. They hate them. They think that the best thing to do would be to shut them all down. I had one gentleman a few years ago who I think reflects some of the thinking, who basically said, if we see a billion or more people killed from starvation in the world, that'd be a good thing. We'd reduce the burden of people on the planet. That's the way they feel. And so why do we put people like that in charge of agencies? This whole thing should be put under control. And we've got an election coming up, and everybody says, how come we don't have jobs? How come unemployment is at 8.2%? How come people are out of work? 23 million Americans can't find jobs. Why? Because we have a government that hates business, hates work, hates wealth. And it filters all the way down from the White House down throughout all these agencies. Something has to be done to get it under control, or they will destroy this great land that we live in and maybe make it pristine for the wolves and the bears and the polar bears and the, you know, bison. Let's save the bison and kill people. That's the thinking. Go ahead.
Well, coming up, a man buys a woman a drink at a club, and this is the next thing she remembers.
I was laying in a closet. I had my hands tied, my legs were tied. And when they took me out of the closet, they raped me. Put me back in a closet like I'm nothing. And I felt like an animal.
Let's see how she escapes after this.
If you have Medicare and have a chronic breathing condition, you can take your medication using an inhaler. Or this, a portable nebulizer from Med for Home. Independent studies have shown a nebulizer may be more effective and easier to use than just an inhaler. Impressive. It's like getting hospital quality treatment at home. So call Med for Home today to find out more. Med for Home is a specialty pharmacy that's here to help you however they can. They'll deal with your doctor, the paperwork, even ship for free. And their pharmacists and respiratory therapists are available 24/7. What's more, your nebulizer and medications may even be covered by your Part B benefits. For a better treatment at a much better price, call Med for Home now to learn how a portable nebulizer can help you start breathing better today. For more information, call 1-800-210-5821.
Wouldn't it be great to win $5,000 a week for life? But wouldn't it be even better if those prize checks kept on coming, even after you're not around?
Introducing the new Publishers Clearinghouse $5,000 a week forever prize. Win, and you'll get $5,000 a week for your life. Then after that, someone you choose gets $5,000 a week for their life. Watch your mail or go to pch.com and enter. August 31st, you could win $5,000 a week forever.
Okay, you're watching the 700 Club. Glad to have you with us. I want to show you something shocking. You think, I hope this doesn't happen often, but it did happen to Lynn Manley. She was at a club doing what she loved best, hunting for men she could hurt before they got a chance to hurt her. But Lynn's plan backfired when a guy at the bar slipped something in her drink. In an instant, he triggered a chain of events that took Lynn back into the living nightmare of her childhood.
I was 9, but I wasn't 9 anymore. I was a woman. I was like a grown-up woman. I felt like I was hurt. I felt like I was betrayed. I felt like, how can someone, an adult, do this to me?
In exchange for a fleeting high, a family member traded Lynn Manley's innocence.
They were on drugs. And they didn't have enough money for the drugs, so they decided to sell me as to get their heroin. The guy took me and had sex with me at 9 years old.
Only one thing brought Lynn any comfort. It was singing hymns she had learned from her great-grandmother.
My great-grandmother sang to me, and she prayed, and I felt the presence of God.
From that moment on, Lynn hated men. And as she got older, she vowed she'd never be hurt by another man again.
I gotta get strong, and I gotta be tough, and I gotta take care of myself. And I looked at men like they were dogs. I felt like everybody was that one man. I felt like if I don't hurt them, they're gonna hurt me.
So Lynn went from one relationship to another with one objective, to hurt as many men as possible. But one night, her plan backfired when she met a man at a club.
He bought me a drink, and I don't know what was in the drink. And I don't even remember anything after that. I just remember that I was laying in a closet. I had my hands tied. My legs were tied. I heard, like, someone coming toward me, and I said, who is it? And when they took me out of the closet, they raped me. Put me back in a closet like I'm nothing. And I felt like an animal. And all I was thinking about is, I can't tell anybody, because they're gonna say, what did you do to deserve that?
The abuse went on for several days before he released her.
And I went to work like nothing happened.
She began dating another man, but soon became pregnant. She knew she couldn't raise the baby on her own, so she decided to turn to God for help.
And then I even remember when I was 9, how painful it was. And I start singing my grandmother's song. I felt there's a difference. There's a big difference, and you can feel him. And I wanted that. I knew he was real. And I said, God, if you help me raise this baby, I will keep her. I went to church and I gave my life to Jesus because I wanted a father for my baby, and he was her dad.
She began attending church regularly, and she says God showed her how to be a mother, but something was still missing.
I was hurting so bad still, even though I had Jesus and love him with all my heart. You have these flashbacks, you know, they come back.
Instead of asking God to fill her void, Lynn began another relationship. She thought he was a Christian, so they married.
And he was very scary, and he was very possessive and mentally and physically abusive. And I was tired of acting like everything's okay and acting like, you know, everything's okay at church, and my home life was bad.
Lynn decided to end her life.
I was like, I can't take it anymore, and I ended up taking pills. Then the next thing, I was in a room, and I heard the voice of God say, I love you, I have a plan for your life, and everything's going to be all right. And it felt like in that room that he was hugging me and holding me, I felt warmth. And I was like, there is no love like this. I've never felt like this in my life.
When Lynn was released from the hospital, she began reading her Bible and grew closer to God. But she says God told her she needed to do one more thing.
He said, now you have to forgive each person. You have to forgive them. And I was like, everybody. And he says, you can't be healed until you forgive. I pray, then I fuss in the middle of my prayer because I was mad. He don't deserve my prayers and he don't deserve to be forgiven. And I would pray and pray and pray until it was real.
Lynn no longer hates men. She's married to Michael, a wonderful husband and father for her daughter, Tiara. Lynn says she's thankful that God has healed her heart and shown her how to forgive.
God can heal you. He can heal you. He is the one that can heal every bit of pain. I am a witness, but you have to forgive. That's when healing comes. I'm so pleased to be a child of God and know that he got my back and he's there for me. You know, it's a wonderful thing to have Jesus and not secondhand Jesus. I know him for myself.
Isn't that something? Sold at 8, later drugged and raped repeatedly. What kind of life is this? But you know, God showed Lynn what's important. And what's important is the love of God. And God forgives. Whatever's been done to you, he says to forgive it. That's hard. It's hard. She said, those guys don't deserve forgiveness. What they ought to have is judgment. But God didn't put us on this earth as judges. He put us on this earth as witnesses to his glory and his love, and to experience his love. The love of Christ, which passes understanding, is more than you and I can comprehend. And right now, what has been done to you? Let me ask you, have you been beat up? Have you got a spouse that beat you? Do you have somebody who's unfaithful? Have you been unfaithful? Have you been raped? Have you been drugged? Have you been abused in some other way? Have you been cheated on? Has somebody stolen money from you? And all these things can build up. But let me tell you, if you harbor resentment, it'll only hurt you. You need to forgive. And you say, well, don't give me this forgiveness stuff. Yeah, it's the way to go. It'll be a release. Because if you harbor it, this thing will eat inside of you like a cancer. Whereas if you get it free and you have the love of God come into your heart, then you will find blessing and peace and healing. I want to pray with you right now. What's been done to you? You know, I don't care how bad it was. It wasn't as bad as what they did to Jesus. And yet he said, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they do. So would you pray with me right now? Let's ask God for forgiveness. Bow your head and pray, Lord, I come to you now, and I confess my sins, for they are many. And Lord, I ask you to forgive me for what I have done. And then, Lord, even as you have forgiven me, I forgive those who have hurt me. Only you know the things that have been done to me and how I've been hurt and wounded. But Lord, I forgive them. And I ask you to cleanse my heart of the hatred I've had against these people. In the name of Jesus, I forgive and I receive your forgiveness. Thank you, Lord. that you've heard my prayer. And thank you that you've come into my heart. I want to pray for you, Father, deliver those. And may all the memories be erased of damage and hurt. And may they be free in the name of Jesus. Amen. And amen. Before we go from this segment, I want to give you something. If you prayed with me, you say, what do I do next? I just prayed a prayer with this guy on TV. What do I do next? Well, I'm going to give you something. It's called A New Day. It's a 73-minute compact disc that tells you about all the things that God has done for you and what He's going to do in the future. And you could have this if you just call us and say, look, I prayed with Pat. I gave my heart to the Lord. Counselors are here on the phones. They love you. 1-800-759-0700. 1-800-759-0700. Just call in and we'll send you free A New Day. And more than anything, you need to tell people what you've just done. Establish it in your heart. You're free. And you are forgiven, and you have forgiven. Christy, what's next?
Thank you so much, Pat. Well, still ahead, the Miami band called Sincere. They are here, and they're playing for us live. Hear how their smooth sound is breaking through the walls of churches and reaching people everywhere.
My God, Jesus, Lord, I'm my life that you got.
Good afternoon. Thank you for calling the 700 Club.
Over that cancerous tumor, just commanding it to be gone.
That's awful, man. We'll pray for you.
Well, there's a lot of hurting people in the world. We're a lifeline for them in their darkest time of need. I come in, I sit down at my station, and the calls will begin coming in. And it's one call after another. And the Lord's faithful. He brings those calls that are supposed to come to my phone, come to me. I'm coming here to try to be a blessing to others, but they're being such a blessing to me. And I walk away with just an encouragement that the Lord is allowing me to make a difference in other people's lives. I'm Donnie Gordon. I'm a prayer partner, and I work at CBN.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is, you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
Call 1-800-284-4105. We will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
Welcome back to the 700 Club. Massachusetts officials have reversed one town's ban on American flags. The housing authority in the town of Wrentham had banned American flags after a tenant made repeated complaints over the 4th of July holiday. They notified residents on Wednesday this week that their flags would have to go. One housing complex in Wrentham even started taking down flags from residents' homes. The Massachusetts Department of Housing, though, issued a statement saying the town's policy was a mistake that is being corrected immediately. Operation Blessing is partnering with Glenn Beck and his organization Mercury One to support a nationwide food drive. It's part of Mercury One's Restoring Love Through Service campaign. The goal is to feed hungry Americans and mobilize volunteers from coast to coast. Operation Blessing will provide 11 tractor-trailer trucks to deliver more than 300,000 pounds of donated food to targeted cities across the nation. The actual Restoring Love event will be held in Dallas, July 26th through the 28th. And you can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to its website at ob.org. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club after this.
My PSA was 14. One day, Janet says, you're going to the doctor. I needed to get a second opinion, so we contacted Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
To find out more about our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com.
If you have prostate or lung cancer or whatever, you can see what their survival rates are.
You can also check for participating insurance plans. Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
I didn't expect to learn a lesson about how to treat people by being in a hospital.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
Monday. The lone survivor from the Navy SEAL's deadliest conflict.
Get me out of here and I'll tell everybody how brave these guys fought.
And how he's serving his country off the battlefield. Plus, Billboard's number one Christian artist. The high-octane music of Sean Locke.
In a live show, in a live setting, people get to see that energy.
Monday on the 700 Club.
All right, are you ready to have some fun? I am. Their name is Sincere, and their video is hot on MTV. They're also the first gospel artist ever to play one of the biggest jazz festivals in Miami, along with, check this out, Patti LaBelle, Mary J. Blige, and Kenny G. But wherever they play, their message is always the same. Here's Sincere performing their smoking hit, I Got Jesus. You got them. We all got them. That was fantastic.
Yes.
James, God bless you. Oh, my goodness. Okay, before I get all into it, which I want to, you got to introduce this phenomenal band.
Okay, well, on the saxophone, we have Clinton Cornish. And on trumpet two, we have Robert Crumity. Then on trumpet one, we have Darrell Effort. And on vocals, we have Terrell Terry, Brian Williams, and Dwayne Charlton. And on the drums, we have Terrence McClain.
Woohoo! Good
and
job.
And on the guitars, we have Wilmire Marsland.
Good to see you.
And on bass, we have Tim Wimberly.
Is that everybody?
That's everybody.
Because there was a lot of people.
Yeah. I'm fumbling trying to get everybody.
No, you did good. Oh, my goodness. You talk about a rocking sound that's just so refreshing.
Yes.
That's kind of, you got the old school of the Temptations. I saw all that choreography. I know y'all worked hard. Come on. I got them. You know, you got that, but then you got the refreshing of just the message of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Tell me about your vision. You started this. This is your baby. This is your heart.
Well, the vision was to be able to go out, take music outside of the walls of the church to get the people and bring them into the church.
Come on.
So, you know, a lot of times we, as artists, get caught up in just ministering to the people in the church when it's the people outside that really need us. So that's what this ministry is basically focused on. That's the purpose of, like, doing the jazz in the gardens and the MTV and everything. Yes.
That's the thing I thought was so cool. You know, you have a video on MTV, so I'm sure you got, you know, Lady Gaga's video first, and then your video comes on second. How ironic and crazy is that, right?
Yes, yes.
But what I love is your music is phenomenal, but what's off the chain, obviously, are your lyrics. You guys didn't play with that. I know we were rocking to the beat, but what are some of the lyrics to this song?
Well, it said, I got Jesus for life, number one. That means no matter what you're going through, as long as you ask him into your heart, he's there. No matter what happens in your life, no matter where you may fall short at, God has got you. As long as you got him in your life, he's there for you.
I love it. Last tag.
Yes.
Last question for you. You guys all are wonderful, godly men.
Yes.
Can I get a smile from everybody? You guys are all kind of standing there like,
yeah.
So what is that thing that, you know, kind of keeps you guys with that same vision, that same place, that you want to be in a godly example? Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, well, basically, we make sure we stay true to what God has us doing. We walk with God. We don't drift off to the side a little bit. You know, we have God in our lives. That's the number one thing. That's how we can succeed in all of this and talk to people about Jesus Christ, and they see Jesus Christ in us. So that's how we do it.
I love it. Last thing, love the suit, by the way.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Okay, where's my camera? Here we go. Sincere's latest CD, here it is, called The Soul of Future Worship. It's available wherever music is sold. And we also have a web exclusive interview with Sincere. All you have to do is just log on to CBN.com and just hit the link in the green room. You could see more about them. All right, y'all. Thank you so much. And you know you got to play us off to break, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're going to play you off to break.
You ready? Go for it. Come on.
One, two, three.
Difficult to sometimes be a Christian and a single these days, right? I mean, wouldn't it be great to actually deal with some of the real issues that Christian singles face and, I don't know, get some form of insight, encouragement, even hope? Yeah, I see you nodding your head. Well, you're gonna love this. Check it out.
We normally ask the wrong questions when we talk to people. The question we ask is, do you love me? That's the wrong question. The right question should be, do you love you?
I don't care if he's the nicest guy on the planet. If he is not submitted to his creator, you don't want him. He will be the end all and be all of his own existence, and you're a toy, you're a trinket that he's trying to collect.
I mean, every now and then I'd like a date or a touch or a kiss or sex. Yes, sex. Sometimes I say to myself, I really want to be married for the wrong reason at this point in time.
Juicy, right? Well, that's just a taste of something new on the 700 Club. Join us every Wednesday for a new series called A Voice of Hope.
Sorry for the delay, folks.
What did we do before cell phones?
Seriously, what did you do?
Two tin cans and some string.
I do like the security of having a cell phone, but I hate paying so much for the minutes I don't use.
Why don't you switch to Consumer Cellular? Their plans start at just $10 a month.
Consumer Cellular is the wireless service designed to save money for people who aren't joined at the hip to their cell phones.
I have Consumer Cellular too, and what I like about it is that there's no contract, and I get discounts for being an AARP member.
Is it a prepaid phone like mine?
No, you get monthly billing.
Oh, and they send usage alerts.
So you can change plans anytime without penalties.
When you switch, you can keep your number and we'll activate your phone for free.
I'm going to call right now.
I thought you guys didn't like talking on the phone.
Funny.
Plans as low as $10 a month with free activation and special discounts for AARP members.
Call Consumer Cellular TV at 1-800-621-6416. Go to consumercellulartv.com or visit a Sears store today.
Welcome back to this edition of the 700 Club. Glad to have you with us. You know, we just had graduations at many, many colleges, and unfortunately, a college degree isn't the ticket to economic success that it used to be. A number of graduates say they can't find jobs that relate to their degrees. Some can't find a job at all. But that's not the case for Vanitha. She's still practicing something she learned in college. And that lesson's paying off in ways she never expected.
CBN partner Vanitha Sivaratnam grew up in Sri Lanka and moved to the U.S. in 1992 to go to school.
I think I've always kind of had it in my heart to give.
Although Vanitha loved to give to others, she didn't learn about tithing until she was in college.
This pastor that I went to church at, he was teaching about tithing, and I got it.
Vanitha learned that the Bible teaches when we give 10% to God, He provides for us. So Vanitha tithed regularly throughout college. The day she graduated, she wasn't worried about finding a job like most grads, because she had landed a job 6 months earlier.
And not only that, you know, they offered me more than what I asked for.
Since then, Vanitha has received a raise each year. She's a product marketing engineer at a computer company. And just recently, her boss surprised her.
He says, we're not giving any raises this year unless it's an exceptional case. And then he turns to me and says, you are the exception. So I ended up getting a raise and a bonus that year.
Vanitha believes there's only one explanation for her financial success.
When you tithe and you walk under the principles of God, He's always kind of watching out for you. You always have that favor, regardless of, you know, what the economy and the natural is doing.
Vanitha loves to give to CBN and Operation Blessing.
Something as simple as glasses, this man did not have, that CBN was able to provide. So it's just very touching to be able to touch an individual like that. And it's not just one individual, that's many people.
Of all the things Vanitha learned in college, there's one lesson she will never forget.
When God says give, you want to give because you don't want to do any other way. But, you know, the way He calls us to do it. So I would encourage you, you know, even if you think it's as small as a mustard seed, give it. You might think it might be minute, but give it to the kingdom. And God sees that, and He would take that and multiply it for His kingdom purposes.
I love her. I think that's beautiful. And she's one of the partners of CBN, 65 cents a day. And Vanitha's got the message, you can change the world. You can make a life better for people. And so we're going to give you, when you join the 700 Club, something called the Three Blessings. Three prayers that I have prayed over the years asking God for. And these are blessings that will change your life. Mm-hmm. You have a comment?
I do. Should we tell them what the blessing is? No. You got to get the DVD, and then you'll know. All right. The Three Blessings is a timely, insightful, and encouraging teaching. I've learned many important truths. Thank you for sharing this richly anointed DVD. That is from a viewer from San Lorenzo, California.
Okay.
Cool. Speaking of cool, let's rock those questions.
Let's rock them, baby.
All right.
Go.
So, Judith begins. She says, Pat, what is your secret for good skin tone?
Well, you know, a long time ago, we had a Dr. Perricone. He had what he called the 28-day facelift or whatever it was. It was a diet thing.
Yeah.
But if you don't want to have bags around hither and yon, what you ought to do is you need to go with low glycemic eating. You ought to get rid of all the white stuff, all the white flour and the white this, that, and the others. Go with whole grains, go with fresh vegetables, go with protein. and it'll make a difference.
And go with good skincare.
We came across something that our good friends at the Lindbergh Company had put out. Judy Lindbergh's mother was a fantastic pioneer in nutrition. Mm-hmm. And so she, I think, came up with this blending of various minerals and fruit and all this stuff. They call it Intense Renewal Serum. And my makeup lady said this is the best thing she'd ever seen. So we use it, and it's good.
Yeah.
You can get it from Lindbergh. No, the last time I mentioned this, they sold out completely.
All I know is I tried to get one, and someone else took it.
Where are they located? They're in California, aren't they?
I don't know.
Read it. What does it say?
Oh, good Lord. California. It's Torrance. Torrance, California.
All right.
Yeah, you know, my contacts.
Lindbergh Nutrition.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right.
Intense
Renewal Serum. Okay, let's get some more questions.
All right, Beatrice wants to know, when someone is dying, do they actually see the angel of death? Years ago, someone who was dying said to me, I see the angel of death over there, and pointed to the corner in their hospital room. What do you think?
I don't think there's such a thing as an angel of death. Some people see Jesus. Some people see the angels. The angels came and carried the beggar, you know, into Abraham's bosom. Mm-hmm. The other one just got thrown into hell. So, you know, but can you see angels? I think, but
can definitely see angels.
But this angel of death stuff, I just don't know about. That sounds like more fiction than anything else.
Yeah,
next question,
know.
Real quick.
Okay, Darius asks, what is the difference between a prophet and a psychic?
Well, a psychic is working on soulish energy, and there are certain precognitions and other things that come through our minds, so there's no question about it. But a prophet is speaking from the Spirit of God, given message from the Spirit of God, and that's what we want to see. We want to see God's Spirit. God never told us to stir up our psychic energy. Mm-hmm. You know, that's what psychology, by the way, speaking about the psyche. Psuche is the soul, not soulish. We don't deal on soulish energy. We deal on spiritual, pneuma. And what you need to do is ask God for His revelation through the Spirit. I guess that's all the time we've got.
That was a really good, insightful answer.
Well, thank you so much.
Well, because, you know, I normally try to jump in, but I couldn't because it was so good.
I'm glad you did.
I love messing with you, Pat.
Yeah, I know you do. All right. Monday, ladies and gentlemen, a former Navy SEAL talks about what's called the greatest victory in the history of the United States Special Forces. And today, we leave you with these words from Luke 12. It is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Remember, our telephones are available all day long at 1-800-759-0700, and we'll see you on Monday. Bye-bye.
Good show.
Wouldn't it be great if you could just hop on a plane and fly to a third world country and hand out food and medicine to the needy? And wouldn't it be great if some of those people came to know Jesus as their Savior because of your help? And wouldn't it be great if you could help out people like this all around the world every day? Wouldn't that make you feel great? And what if you could do all of this without having to leave your home or write monthly checks? Well, you can. Partner with CBN and you can help spread the gospel to people all around the world and make it a better place. And when you sign up for Pledge Express, your contribution will be deducted from your bank account every month automatically. It's a safe and simple way to make a difference. Plus, wouldn't it be great to get life-changing teachings every month from Pat and Gordon? When you sign up for Pledge Express, you'll save time and money, and you won't just sit around and watch the world go by. You'll help change it for the glory of God. Now, wouldn't that be great?